neither can the ground of them be found out.
Too enormous, man. I mean, we can't even imagine. Can't even imagine, right?
When a man has done, then he beginneth. And when he leaveth off, then he shall be doubtful.
When a man is done, then he beginneth. So whatever you're doing, you start doing something, that's the beginning of doing something. You leave off, you start doubting. And that's the wrong thing. It does cancel out what?
Faith.
Right, cancel out faith.
Therefore, the Most High is patient with them and pours forth his mercy upon them. He saw and perceived their end to be.
And verse 22.
Ecclesiastes chapter 19, verse 22. The knowledge of wickedness is not wisdom.
The knowledge of wickedness is what?
Not wisdom.
Not wisdom. Go ahead.
Neither at any time the counsel of sinners, prudence.
Yeah. Neither at any time the counsel of sinners, gonna bring forth wisdom. Jump to verse 19.
The knowledge of the commandments of the Most High on our scripture side is the doctrine of life.
The knowledge of the commandments is the doctrine of life. Read.
And they that do things that please him shall receive the fruit of the tree of immortality.
You do things that please the Most High, you will receive of the fruit of the tree of immortality. You have a chance to live forever and ever and ever. Go ahead.
The fear of the Most High, my second side, is all wisdom.
Yeah, the fear of the Most High, my second side, is all wisdom. Read.
And in all wisdom is the performance of the law.
All wisdom is what?
The performance of the law.
Performance of the law that the Most High gave us. Moral law, civil law, dietary laws, and ceremonial laws at this day and time. The sacrificial law was done away from the Mashiach Kabashai, died in the tree. Now we, our bodies got to be a living sacrifice. We got to sacrifice. Read.
And the knowledge of his omnipotency.
And the knowledge of his omnipotency, man, cannot be measured. Up to verse 18.
The fear of the Most High, Mashiach Kabashai, is the first step to be accepted of him. And wisdom obtaining his love.
The fear of the Most High is the first step to be accepted of him. And wisdom obtaining his love. His love not for everyone. Verse 17.
Admonish thy neighbor before thou threaten him.
Admonish him, correct him before you threaten him, read.
And not being angry.
You don't do it while you're angry.
Give place to the law of the Most High.
That's right. Give place to the law of the Most High. You got to think about what's right. That's why I said, if you don't know what's right, you can't just operate in what you're dealing with without knowing that. You got to be right in the eyes of the Most High, first and foremost. To make sure, because it's going to be the love for each other to make you better, make us all, make ourselves better and not worse. You can look at it. If you don't know love, then you don't understand how to admonish your brother can make you better. Get Ecclesiastes 18 and 14.
Ecclesiastes chapter 18, verse 14. He had mercy on them that received discipline.
See, he had mercy. What's mercy? What's mercy?
Giving something. Not getting what you do deserve.
What?
Not getting what you do deserve.
Not getting something that you do deserve. Okay. He have mercy, not giving you what you do deserve, on them that receive discipline. Okay?
And that diligently seek after his judgment.
Diligently seek after his judgment. But you gotta be disciplined. What is that? It say he have mercy on them that receive discipline. If they discipline, what's the discipline? What do you think they got? What comes out of this discipline? Let's see if I got that word.
Cycle.
The cycle is what? One that's learning. That's learning. Once you learn, you become unlocked. See, there was a cycle at first. Then it became a apostle. Once they knew that they have been taught. Read verse 20.
Ecclesiastes, chapter 18, verse 20. Before judgment, examine thyself.
Before judgment, examine yourself. Read.
And in the day of visitation, thou shalt find mercy.
Yeah. So he said, before the judgment, examine yourself. That's why he said, we got to take full self-examination of ourselves all the time. In the day of visitation, you're going to find mercy. You know you'll have mercy on who? Jacob. And when yet you
be sick, and in the time of sins show repentance.
I say, God, humble ourselves before we sin. So why can't we do well? We got to humble ourselves. You humble yourself before the Most High, going through His Word, follow what He's saying, and you can do it. That's why it says, examine yourself. Like, examine yourself. In day of visitation, when you come, He give you mercy. Give you mercy, whatever you want. Humble yourself before you be sick. That's that pride coming up. The next thing you know, you fall sick. And in the time of sins, show repentance. You've done wrong, you got to repent. You got to ask for forgiveness. This Psalm 69. Psalm 69:32.
Psalm chapter 69, verse 32. The humble shall see this and be glad, and your heart shall live that seek the Most High of us shall.
Read it again.
Psalm chapter 69, verse 32. The humble shall see this and be glad, and your heart shall live that seek the Most High of us shall shine.
You better live the ones that seek the Most High of us shall shine now. You gotta seek Him while He can be found. He ain't everywhere to be found. Isaiah 34:16.
Isaiah chapter 34, verse 16. Seek ye out the book of the Most High and read. No one of these shall fail, none shall want her mate. For my mouth it hath commanded, and His Spirit it hath guided them.
See, you got to seek out the book of the Most High, this Bible, and what? And read. And He said, just listen to it. No, it says, seek ye out of the book of the Most High and read. Say, no one of these shall fail. None shall go on her way. You can't match any book with this Bible. For my mouth, He said, it has commanded in His Spirit. It has gathered them, these words that's in this Bible. Isaiah 8:20.
Isaiah chapter 8, verse 20. To the law and to the testimony, if they speak not according to this word, it is because there is no light in them.
To the law and to the testimony, they speak not according to the word of this Bible, it is because what?
There is no light in them.
There is no light in them. There's no light. Meaning they don't have what? They don't have what? There's no light in this. They don't have what?
The law.
What's the answer? The laws. Huh? How you know that? That's right. What's the light? How you prove the light?
Proverbs 6:23.
It. The law of the testimony, they speak not according to this word because there's no light in them. And that's very important that we understand this light, because it means this light. Remember, He said He spoke in parables. The mystery of the kingdom of the Most High. You gotta go back there, but we never finished it. But who will remind you? Only the Holy Spirit. Read
Proverbs chapter 6, verse 23.
Right.
For the commandment is a lamp.
The commandment is a lamp. Read.
And the law is light.
And the law is light. Read.
And reproof of instruction.
Reproof of instruction. what says discipline, man. It's all about discipline. Being disciplined, we all have to have discipline. I mean, whatever you do is some kind of discipline that you have to follow. You gotta go, you catch in a train, you gotta be patient enough, wait till you come there. And if somebody's in front of you, you gotta wait, step up, right? Step up till it's your turn to get on the train, get your money in, or whatever means you use to ride on there, to do that. Everything. The bus, everything. Everything you do, I'm just saying, Lord, I'm just saying, everything we do has order. You gotta be disciplined. God, certain way you act. Straight up. See, what they want is order by chaos. So if you're chaotic, yeah, you're right in order with the Illuminati. You're right in order with them. They don't want us to be disciplined. They don't want us to be together. That's the problem they have. See, we're all together. One thing about it, one thing I'll say, Dr. Ben, you know, we as Hebrews, like, we all need these laws on the Most High. That's the power. Because you love me, you do what?
Keep
my commandments. But this is the love of the Most High. We keep his commandments. Commandments are not grievous. So that's right there, is bringing us back. Contrary to what the Gentiles and these other nations, these other pastors and so forth have taught us, that we're not under the law. But we're in a mercy of grace. And that's how you see us coming together. Because how are we going to come together? In following the Most High. Rather than not following him, but following him. You understand? Following his rules and regulations. Contrary to the rules and regulations of the world. They say you ain't got to follow him. That's what they're saying. You don't have to follow the Most High. Regardless of anybody challenges that, if they tell you you have to follow the laws of the Most High, they just say you have to follow the law. They don't add of the Most High. We add that because that's who laws are. Who gave us the laws? The Most High. So you're saying you ain't got to follow. I ain't got to follow the Most High. Put it to them just like that. You're saying you ain't got to follow the Most High. When we read Exodus 20th chapter, I mean, who said it? Who's the one that the finger of the Most High wrote on tablets? The laws that he gave to us, 613 laws to the children of Israel. He gave it to us. You're going to say, oh, he wasted his time. That don't mean nothing. That's why they're going to be what? The least in the kingdom of heaven. And those that do and teach the law will be what? The greatest in the kingdom of heaven. And my Shaq Darashai said that out of his own mouth. So who's going to dispute that? I don't see much dispute in that at all, except for those that preparing themselves for the lake of fire, for that hell fire. That's who's going to be the least in the kingdom of heaven. We got to observe this, man. This is very important. Get 1 Peter 5 and 1.
But willingly.
example, being as a shepherd, as an elder, y'all being an example to the flock. Whereas you look at, okay, well, there's no excuse because you ain't even an example. Everybody gotta be an example. You've been an example as a people. Man, I can't say much, but man, you need it. Man, so what it could just be. Who could complain? I can say nothing. You know, you've been an example of the flock. They look at, wow, okay, you tapping somebody to see that diligent, disciplined, you know, be an example of the flock so everybody can see how it's supposed to be, baby.
And when the chief shepherd shall appear, ye shall receive a crown of glory that fadeth not away.
That's right. That's right. When you gonna appear, so you're gonna receive a crown of glory that shall not disappear. Come here.
Likewise, ye younger, submit yourselves unto the elder.
This orders may say, you younger, submit yourselves unto the elder. Go ahead.
Yeah, all of you be subject to one to
another.
Yeah, all of you be subject one to another.
That's right. So it says, you younger brothers, this is something I look at all the time, right? How long you been in the truth, brother? Well, I've been in a couple of years, you check me. Submit yourself to the elder. And to be off, these new doctrines coming out. One thing I'll say, man, I love the old, and I can add, Holy Spirit add it to what it is to get it. Because the scriptures change. Do the scriptures change? The scriptures don't change, right? So how do you eliminate them? Okay, do they eliminate scriptures? They come up with this new doctrine, they don't come up with the same thing that we get. See, all of us see the same thing, basically. So if the Holy Spirit is going to be demanding other things to get more understanding as we go further and further, right? Not take away, don't take away and say, oh no, I'll take away all these here over here. Now you come with this doctrine here. But yet still you're going to try to integrate with some of these scriptures in with it, but not the whole breakdown that we all get given. Or some got the breakdown and we found out we was wrong. You see? Holy Spirit said, no, that wasn't right. Because we make mistakes. See, but your mind has to be open so the Holy Spirit can come in and be able to tell you how to be disciplined. To hear it. To know what we're supposed to know. That's why it's telling you, I'll tell you, I don't have no idea where I'm going. But the Holy Spirit will bring it. That's why I said, I don't know, of course, so I can look at what's going to have been brought out so I can go over it myself. Why are you listening to that? I'm listening to that. I ain't listening to myself. I'm listening to a word that's coming out. You know what I mean? So I can hear what it is out here. Because nobody give me. I ain't got nothing that y'all have. I don't have this. But I'll have it if I go over it again to study. Just keep on studying to get more and more and more. Like what I have now, I'm going to look at tapes from the beginning, from the 90s. What was brought out. Now there's so much more that's added to what we knew from the beginning. See what I'm saying? I have a guideline of what was given to me. Now I'm just getting grew so much and gave so much from that time to now that y'all getting stuff that made y'all another level. That I wasn't there when I was, I didn't know these things. I wasn't taught these things. The Holy Spirit revealed certain things in this time. As it was time to reveal it. That's why you can't just close your mind up to the knowledge, man, and the wisdom and the understanding. You gotta take this and go with it. And as you know, you start seeing certain things come in, this will start helping you to see more and bring it to the table. Instead of just being as a student, as a disciple, you become apostles. Because it's all here. Okay, I heard that already. You heard it, okay, you heard it, but what scripture changes? Then I ask the question, you don't know where it's at. You see what I'm saying? Certain things you gravitate to, some things you don't. So you look at these younger brothers that's looking at, okay, elders, man, come on. How you gonna smack down an elder when he tell you to be younger, submit yourself to the elder? That's discipline. Read that again, verse 5.
1 Peter chapter 5, verse 5. Likewise, ye younger, submit yourselves unto the elder.
The young brothers supposed to submit themselves to the elder. Read.
Yeah, all of you be subject one to another.
Be subject one to another. That don't mean that he already laid it out. We ain't gonna be no tyrants over the brothers. You see what I'm saying? When we say, but the Lord, that's how the Gentiles are. Say, but we ain't supposed to be like that. We're supposed to be You know, because the Most High, who we love?
Jacob.
He loves Jacob, so who are we not to love? Who the Most High loves? He loves our people. It's just a matter of, we gotta understand how this love gotta come. It ain't gonna come back. That's why I went to in the spirit, the balance of things. It will always be one way. It's gonna be, you gotta deal with all types of spirit that we have to deal with at any time. You gotta remember, we're going back to what? The love. Keeping the commandments of the Most High. To know this order, to better each other. Because one thing about it, however come to you, it's gonna come to you. I can bring it up a certain way, it's gonna come to me that same way. I gotta think about it. If I'm wrong, I know I'll be dealt with. And I know I fear the Most High. And I know he said, okay, well, he wants you to be right. That's all. Just be right. You know what I'm saying? Just be right. So you know, okay, well, man, I gotta get it together. Or however it is that you see that, like I said, we gotta what? Be subject one to another. One to another. Certain things you're gonna bring to the table. That's the body of a Mashiach Yahushua. You and everybody gonna bring something to the body of a Mashiach Yahushua. That's how we subject one to another. But he still have order. Still gonna be in order. It's gotta be done decently and in order. Read it on the top.
1 Peter chapter 5, verse 5. Chapter 5, verse 5.
You understand, this is very important because it's leading up to something. But read it.
Likewise, ye younger, submit yourself unto the elder.
Younger, submit yourself to the elder, okay?
Yeah, all of you, be subject one to another.
We all be subject one to another, man. As soldiers of the Most High, read.
And be clothed with humility.
Be clothed with humility. So, I mean, you can take no credit for this. I'll take credit for this. I ain't wrote damn scripture. I'm gonna take credit for this. You know what I mean? Give all praise and glory to the Most High. Always remember Moses. You know,
right?
Always remember. You're Moses there, right? With that rock. Moses said, speak to the rock. I'm going to bring my water. Boy, Moses, Israel, God was there. Bam, bam. Hit that rock twice. And brought the rock. He brought the water through. Moses said, hey, man. That's why it's important to give the Most High all the praise. Be the Most High of praise. Even though you can be thankful and you thank each other and so forth, but give the Most High, get used to giving the Most High the praise. Give the Most High praise, the Most High praise, the Most High praise, the Most High. As much as we can, man. That's why we can say, I know y'all, okay, I think I said it 1,000 times, you say it. I know y'all. If I don't play too bad, I'm gonna say it by myself. I know y'all. To the Most High. Because he wanted you praise. You know, it's mercy and grace, man. We do it for us. Miracles, you know. I see miracles, but miracle-wise. You know what I mean? It's like, people tell people about you all the time, grab you on the phone, but I'm like, man, it's a miracle, brother. That's a miracle, brother. You know what I'm saying? It's that many that can endure and be down like you are, brother. You know? Miracle. Like you said, all week long. You can't do that. You recognize, you examine yourself, and you realize, okay, man, that's a sign of growth, that's a sign of maturity. That's what this is about, man. Maturing in this, and not being immature in this. In the love, man, in the Most High God, man, He got us. We just got to remember, always give Him the praise. Everything is from Him. Get used to giving him the praise about Shema Mashiach Yahushua. So he's gonna bring his wrath upon us. His angels, where? They right here, man. They waiting for the commandment of the Most High to deal with us. So I give him all the praise, man. Always get used to that, man. Because without him, we can do nothing. Nothing. Just know that we gotta work on ourselves. We all gotta work on ourselves, man. Get better and better. And as simple as that, man. He's gonna bless us. Continue to bless us. You're going to see us through everything. We just got to follow those orders, man, because it's very important. Keep on reading. Verse 6. I don't know if you can verse 5. Go ahead.
For the Most High resisted the proud.
He resisted the proud, man.
Read. And give it grace to the humble.
Give grace to the humble. We've been talking about all day, what? What have we been talking about mostly all day? Besides grace. I've been asking you every time. said, and giving grace to the humble. We've been talking all day about what?
Mercy. Mercy. We haven't really dealt with grace.
We've been dealing with mercy. Which is what?
Mercy is giving something that you don't deserve.
Okay, well, what's mercy?
Not getting something you do deserve.
Yeah, so you wrote it down. Sometimes you need to look at your notes. Because I would ask you every time, right? That's why I ask you every time.
You said the tongue twister, so you
No, no,
man, it's a tongue twister.
No, no, it's a tongue twister. You gotta think about this. This is how this is thing. This is how you've been bad. And you know you're sitting there, you know you're gonna get a whooping.
Uh-huh.
Just think, because you might not have got a whooping. You know you're gonna get a whooping. And you there, hey, think about it. Come and say, you know what, I ain't gonna work for you. That's mercy. Not getting something that you do deserve. You know you deserve to get that work. You gotta find what you did. You come and say, hey, look, I'm gonna let you slide this time. That's what I'm talking about. That's mercy. Grace is getting something that you don't deserve. You've been bad all week. Both of y'all have been bad all week. Coming home. Teachers calling home, talking about, ah, oh, man, they just killed my neighbor. I'm gonna kick them out of school. Then you take them to magic mountain. You know, they've been bad all week long. And then y'all put a bad mouth. That's grace. Getting something that you don't deserve. And that's where we're at, sin against the Most High. He's giving us grace. And that's giving something that we don't deserve. Unless you cry. You know, read. God resists the proud and gives grace to the humble. Go ahead.
Humble yourself, therefore, under the mighty hand of the Most High, that He may exalt you in due time.
We got to humble ourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of the Most High, that He may exalt us in due time. And the exaltation that we're looking for is what? The ultimate exaltation for us is what? What's the ultimate exaltation for us?
Everlasting life.
There it is! Everlasting life! Come on! Go ahead!
Casting all your care upon Him, for He cared for you.
You are casting all your cares upon the Most High, for He cares for us. Me?
Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, has a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour.
Baby. We gotta be sober, vigilant, because our adversary, our enemy, who? The devil, is going where? Where you going? Up and down, to and fro, where?
In the earth,
man. In the earth. Seeking whom? Seeking whom?
Whom He may devour.
Whom He may devour. As it's written. It don't take a rocket science to figure this out, y'all. Doing all that, just asking you questions that's in the scriptures. That we just read. All you gotta do is, you can't see. And hopefully, one of them that's seeing and can't see, can't perceive and hear, but can't understand. Okay, one of them, because it's right there. I'm telling you, everything I'm asking is making sure that you understand what we read. No more, no less. It's right there. And that's how you learn how to operate with these precepts, understanding how to go about bringing forth the Spirit.